So very good morning to all the students. Today we will start with our new topic, that is structural dynamics. Basically, I have chosen this topic because this contain the very basic part of the dynamics and theoretical parts. Also, one information I would like to share with you that from the first week of November, your CAT 1 is going to be started. The timetable will soon display to you through WhatsApp or by some other media like Google Classroom by your coordinator. So basically, as it contains the basic part of the dynamics and some theory is also covered in this unit, and it is always asked in your examination in question number 11 or 12, and I have decided the portion for your CAT 1 as the two unit as pure numerical and one unit as a theory. So that's why I have considered this unit number 6 to be start earlier than unit number 3 and 4 and 5. So let us see what is the basic of structural dynamics. So first of all, what is dynamics? So the word dynamic simply means the change with time. So the basic difference between the static and dynamic loading. So in case of static, the resistance due to internal elastic forces of the structures. Whereas in a static problem, response due to the static loading is displacement only. This is the particular state of static. Whereas if the load is acting in terms of T, okay, and the change in interval of time of T is there in case of dynamics. So the acceleration producing the inertia forces, that is the inertia force, form a significant portion of load equilibrated by the internal elastic force of the structures. So in dynamic problem, the response due to the dynamic loading is in the form of displacement, velocity and acceleration. That is, in dynamic you will get the three result, that is displacement, velocity and acceleration. So some common causes of dynamic effect in the structures are initial condition. First of all, initial conditions such as velocity and displacement produces the dynamic effect in the system. For example, consider a lift moving up or down with the initial velocity. So when the lift is suddenly stopped, the cabin begins to vibrate up and down since it possesses the initial velocity. So this is the best example of the dynamic effect. Then second one is the applied force. Sometimes vibrations in the system is produced due to the application of the external forces. For example, is building subjected to bomb blast or wind forces. So this is also an example of the dynamic effect. Then machine foundation. Machine foundation in the support an industrial building is there. And there is a huge vibrated machine is there in second and third floor. And if that machine is working, then because of that, the floor of the building is also vibrate. So this is also a type of a vibration effect because of the applied force. And third important part is the support motion. Structure are often subjected to the vibration due to the influence of support motion. For example, earthquake motion. So basically, the earthquake which comes below the earth, either in horizontal direction or in vertical direction, so because of that the building is tried to displace from its original position. Okay, so these are the some of the most common causes of the dynamic effect in the structure. Now the basic concept of the structural dynamics, these are the most important definition you must understand. Okay, because whatever the definition, whatever the part I will explain in this PPT, they are always asked in your examinations. So if you see question number 11 or 12, the theory which I will going to explain today, these are always asked in your examination. So first of all, vibration and oscillation. So if the motion of the structure is oscillating, that is a pendulum, okay, so in that case, so vibration and oscillation, if motion of the structure is oscillating, that is pendulum or reciprocatory along with the deformation of the structure, it is termed as a vibration. So in case there is no deformation, which implies only the rigid body motion, is termed as oscillation. Second is free vibration. So vibration of the system which is initiated by the force which is subsequently withdrawn, and hence it, the vibration occurs without the external force, is called free vibration. Whereas force vibration is if the external force is responsible or involved during the vibration, then it is called force vibrations. Next is damping. So damping is nothing but all the real structure, real life structures, when subjected to the vibration, resist it. So due to this, the amplitude of the vibration gradually reduces with respect to time, and in case of free vibration, the motion is damped out eventually, and the damping forces depends upon the number of factors, and it is very difficult to quantify them. Okay, so the common use representation is viscous damping, wherein damping force is expressed as F of suffix D is equal to C of X, where X dash can be represented as the velocity and C represented as a damping constant. So dynamic degree of freedom. So first of all, the number of independent displacement component that must be considered to represent the effect of all the significant inertia forces of the structure is called degree of freedom. And depending upon the coordinate to describe the motion, there are three main type of degree of freedom. First is single degree of freedom system, that is called as SDOF. Second is multi degree of freedom system, that is MDOF. And third is continuous systems. Okay, so in our syllabus, we are having only single degree of freedom systems. Okay, so this definition is also always asked in your examinations. If you refer to your paper, so you will see in n number of paper this type of question were asked as a part of short notes or definitions. So you must remember this single degree of freedom system. So let's see step by step. So first of all, single degree of freedom system is nothing but if a single coordinate is sufficient to define the position or the geometry of the mass of the system at any instant of time is called as a single or one degree of freedom system. Similarly, multi degree of freedom system is nothing but if more than one independent coordinate is required to completely specify the position or the geometry of the different masses of the system at any instant of time is called as multi degree of freedom system. And continuous system is nothing but if a mass of a system may be considered to be distributed over its entire length, okay, as shown in figure, figure is there in next slide. So in which the mass is considered to have an infinite degree of freedom, so it is referred as a continuous system. So it is also called as a distributed system. So let us see, this is the best example of single degree of freedom system. So this tower, if you see that this tower represent the single degree of freedom system. So mathematically it can be idealized as a single mass and system, and it is supported by a column, stiff column, okay, and at the base it is fixed by the foundation effect. So mathematically it can be generated in this way. So if the vibration force, or if you can say the horizontal force, will be acting on the structure, suppose this is a tower and we know that the wind effect is very very predominant for such type of high-rise structures. So in that case, the structure is tried to vibrate either in rightward direction and leftward direction. So this displacement with respect to time can be calculated in terms of x of t, okay, and the stiffness can be calculated, k of the column can be calculated as 3EI by L cube. Okay, so it formed the idealization of the tall structures. Similarly, we can also form an equivalent spring mass model. Suppose one fixed support is there, fixed part is there, and if it is attached with a spring of stiffness K, having one end and other end having a mass m, and if it is applied with a force of xt, displacement in terms of t, x represent the displacement and t is the time, okay? So this is also a one type of a single mass or single degree of freedom system. Similarly, this pendulum is also example of this, okay? The mass is suspended by using a spring, okay? So these are the some of the example of single degree of freedom system. So single degree of freedom system is nothing but a mathematical modeling in which we can clearly specify a mass and the column in a more effective way, okay? So that representation is called as a single degree of freedom system, and then accordingly we can calculate the displacement with respect to time and the forces, okay? One universal equation is there to solve this type of numericals. If you know the D'Alembert principle, we have already seen in I think first year in engineering mechanics, the D'Alembert principle. So these all equations are comes from D'Alembert's equations, okay? So this is the vertical translation, second one is a horizontal, and third is a horizontal translation, and finally rotation. Then multi-degree of freedom system. So in multi-degree of freedom system, the difference is that only the number of mass will be more than one. If you see that m1 is there, and along with m1, m2 is also attached, okay? So for m2, the stiffness of the column or if stiffness of the spring which is responsible for attaching the mass is k2, whereas for m1, k1 is the spring, and both are connected with each other, and finally it is connected with a fixed support. So this is the example of multi-degree of freedom system. So by this way you can attach n number of masses with different stiffnesses, and according to that we can apply the number of forces like x1, x2 or displacement x1 and x2 as per our requirement. So let us see the definition. If more than one independent coordinate is required to completely specify the position or the geometry of the different mass of the system at any instant of time, this is called as a multi-degree of freedom system, okay? Then next is continuous system. So this is the best example of continuous system. So this is the best example. If you see that a cantilever beam with an infinite number of degree of freedom, okay, this is a best example of cantilever beam, or you can say that it is nothing but a mathematical modeling of cantilever beam is there, and this beam is divided into n number of segments, okay, and at each segment the displacement is calculated. So by this way we can call it as this is a continuous system. So if a mass of a system may be considered to be distributed over its entire length as shown in figure, so in this case in which the mass is considered to have infinite degree of freedom, and it is referred as a continuous system, and it is also known as the distributed system. This is the example. Now the most important part is how to form the mathematical modeling of single degree of freedom. So for forming the mathematical modeling, this diagram you must understand very very carefully. So this is the ideal example of a single degree of freedom system. So first of all, this is a fixed part is there, and along with that k is represent the stiffness, c represent your dashpot, that is called as a friction factor, okay? M is the mass of the structure, x is nothing but a displacement component, p is the external force component is there with respect to time. So these factor you have to be assume, okay? This factor you have to be assume for single degree of freedom system, okay? As this is a single degree of freedom system, therefore only one mass is attached. Suppose if you are looking for multi degree of freedom system, okay, so along with that one more mass or n number of mass you can add, okay, for multi degree of freedom system. So let us see how this will be calculated. So we know that summation of F is equal to mass into acceleration. So where this force is equal to mass into acceleration comes from, this is the Newton's second law. If you know that, it is a Newton's second law. So summation of F, if you apply it here, so here you will get summation of F is equal to mass into acceleration. X double dot in this dynamic is represented as acceleration. Okay, and X single dot will represented as velocity. Okay, velocity acceleration. Then is equal to PT. This is PT. Okay, then PT is going in rightward direction. So therefore it is PT in rightward direction, positive. Then minus C of X. This minus C of X will be considered. Okay, and kx will be considered. So x represent displacement. Okay, if you partially displace this displacement, you will get velocity, and if you again partially displace, then you will get acceleration. So here you will get three result. First is acceleration, second is your velocity, and first is your displacement, second is your velocity, and third is your acceleration. So these three component you will get at the end. So this is the m. If you solve this, okay, then you will get mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx is equal to pt. So this equation is called as the equation of dynamics. This is the equation of dynamics. And this was first introduced by D'Alembert. Therefore, this equation is also known as the D'Alembert equations. Okay, so let us see the various parts or the symbol of the equations. So mass element is M. It represents the mass and inertia characteristic of the structure. Whereas spring element K is K. Represent the elastic restoring forces and the potential energy capacity of the structure. And dashpot C represent the frictional characteristic and the energy losses of the structure. And excitation force P in terms of time interval represent the external force acting on the structure. So you must understand this equation. Okay, this equation you must understand. Next is mathematical modeling of single degree of freedom system. So as we know that we can apply two types of vibration. First is free vibration, second is force vibration. So under free vibration, two categories are there. Undamped vibration. So undamped vibration is there if the condition is C is equal to 0 and PT is equal to 0. That will call undamped. Okay. And second is damped vibration. In that case, C is not equal to 0 but P is equal to 0. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to put these conditions in your previous equation, this, and you will get the final output. Okay, similarly, in force vibration, what are the condition? First is undamped, C is equal to your 0 and your PT is equal to not 0. Similarly, for damped, C is not equal to 0 but PT is also not equal to 0. So this is the example of the force vibration of undamped and damped vibration. So what you have to do, you have to apply these boundary condition in this equation. So finally you will get the free vibration and force vibration equation. So let us see. So differential equation describing the motion is known as the equation of motion. First is simple harmonic motion. So this is the representation of simple harmonic motion. X double dot plus Wn square x is equal to 0. So in this case, x double dot represent the acceleration of the motion, Wn represent the frequency, okay, and x represent the displacement character. Okay, so this is the final output of the equation. We have to concentrate on this equation only. Okay, we do not required to solve the detailed derivation for this equations. Second is Newton's second law of motion. So what it represent? Mx double dot is equal to minus kx. So if you partially derivate with respect to acceleration, then you will get mx with respect to m, so you will get x double dot plus k by m x plus is equal to 0. Okay, So this is the second equation. Then energy method. We know that kinetic energy plus potential energy must be equal to constant. So in that case, d by dt is equal to half mx square dot plus half kx square dot. So this is the energy method. Third is Rayleigh-Gray-Leg methods. So in this case, x is equal to a sin omega t, that is equal to half mx dot max square, that is equal to half kx max square. And finally, D'Alembert's methods. So in that case, inertia force is equal to Fi is equal to mx double dot, that is equal to minus mx double dot minus kx equal to 0, that is equal to mx double dot plus kx equal to 0. So by observing all these equations, you must understand the different type of equation of motion which is applicable for the different type of methods. Okay, so in our syllabus, that is in unit number 6, we only you have to concentrate on this D'Alembert's and this Rayleigh-Gray methods. Okay, so by this you can solve the dynamics numericals. Then the next is simple harmonic motion. So if the acceleration of the particle in the rectilinear motion is always proportional to the distance of the particle from a fixed point on the path and is directed towards the fixed point, then the particle is to be said as simple harmonic motion. So SHM is the simplest form of periodic motions. Okay, so in the differential equation form, it can be represented as alpha x directly proportional to minus x. Okay, so final equation will become x double dot plus omega n square x equal to 0. Okay, this equation, this is known as a equation of motion and a second order linear differential equations. Okay, then Newton's second law of motion. The rate of change of momentum is proportional to the impressed force and takes place in the direction in which the force act. So consider a spring mass model. This is the best example to calculate the omega, that is frequency. So mass of the system of figure, which is assumed to move only along the vertical direction. It has only one degree of freedom system, and because of its motion, it is described by single coordinate x. So according to Newton's second law, mx double dot is equal to minus kx. So therefore, mx double dot plus kx equal to 0. So therefore, x dot plus k by m x is equal to 0. Okay, so finally, compare this equation with respect with simple harmonic motion. We have already seen in previous slide. So x double dot plus w n omega square omega n square x is equal to 0. So this is the equation number 1, 2, 3. So finally, omega n square is equal to k by m. And finally, omega n is equal to under root of k by n always. Okay, so if you see the diagram, first is static deflection is there. Second, if you the mass is suspended and if the force of x is applied continuously in the downward direction, then it can be represented as a free body diagram. In third diagram, that is m is there, w is going in downward direction, and k delta, okay, stiffness of the spring is there, and delta is the displacement is to be formed in opposite direction. And then finally, we will get in dynamic part m, then w is downward, then in upward part you will get k in bracket delta plus x. Okay, so what delta represent? Delta represent the deflection in the spring, k represent the stiffness of the spring, and x represent the displacement. And the two arrow which is shown in downward direction, if you see that, this, so x dot represent the velocity, whereas x double dot represent the acceleration. So by this way, statically and dynamically, you can calculate the different form of result. Then energy method. So this part we will cover in our next lecture. Okay.